Everybody, it's P98, it's Cousin. Right now I'm about to customize Misty. A paintbrush. I need a new paintbrush, but I need one of these. And I need a paint tray. If you got this kind of paint, I recommend this kind of paint. I'm making her black, and I'm gonna give her some white points. And I'm using glossy. So I poured the paint in these in right here and here, and let's get ready. I would recommend having a practice mold if you don't know what to do, so you want to like see what looks good. I would recommend having it can be like an old breyer. I'm using the blackjack mold. I've painted in white, so I can look at what colors look like. He's got two broken legs, so I just practice on him. I've already done a few practices on him. I paint back over my practices, just so like I can do more. So let's get started. This is my nightshirt. But I'll also make it a painting shirt. So what I'm going to start first is doing her mane and tail. So I'm going to face her towards me because this is where most of her mane is. Mane and tail are. So first I'm going to get my brush. I'm going to just get it on the mane all over there. And with this mold, when painting, I would recommend doing the mane and tail first. That way you can like paint back over your flaws. I'll just like get the brush and I'll just like do that. So I can like, it's kind of hard to see where the mane is. And I don't want to like make her mane look all tacky. Yeah, this is a process. So this is step one, doing the mane and tail. It's really a process here, obviously. You gotta get like usually with the mane and tail, I try using a smaller type of brush. I recommend it. You don't have to do it, but I recommend doing a smaller brush, getting those itty bitty little cracks and crevices all in the mane and tail, like the textures. Wow, this gets boring. It's quiet in here. The finish of this will be real, real glossy. Right now, I'm not really caring if I'm getting it on the mold because I'm doing this first. So, here's the ending of the mane. And I'm getting the forelock right now. I believe that's what it's called. I'm not the best when I'm doing stuff. I'm not the best namer. So, we're getting... Now we're seeing a little crack in the crevices underneath the mane. Dents, cracks, everything. And I just got the back of her ear. I just hit it with my brush. I would recommend having some like old pants or clothes right now. I'm not following that rule because this is a new shirt. But that's nice. It is permanent paint. So that's all we need. Some permanent paint with a new shirt. That's my brother. He's probably gonna come in here and start talking to me. Here's the finishing mane. just to finish painting, and I'm getting on the tail. There it goes. I don't really know. I don't know, brother. Tail has a lot of cracks and crevices. But if like your whole horse is about to gut, probably gonna be the same color. Not such big of a problem, but if like you're making it like a bay. Ouch, I stay on tail. Because when your horse, if like, say this was a black and I want to paint it white, I'm going to have to like three coats of white going over it. Because it's really hard for blacks to turn back to the coat for white to go over black. I'm going to find a way to put this in fast motion. Just don't give your brush a bed head. That's what I did once when I didn't know so much about painting the horse. My brush looked really horrible after painting. Like, when you're painting, be like firm but gentle. That's what you should do. Be firm but gentle. Oh, I missed a spot on the mane. Okay. There we go. Upside down. Gotta get in every little tight space. Right now, I'm getting underneath the tail. On the dock. There we go. Yay, you need a horse. I need a part on the horse without saying, no. Sometimes, like, with the glossy, it's really, really hard because, like, it'll, like, shine on a place to make it look white or white or whatever color, and really, you already painted it. So, that's what you gotta watch out for, but it's always good to, like, double coat it. This paint smells really bad. I don't like it. Now painting the body, the video will be long, longer than this. I might, like, just do a little half of the body. Like, go ahead and paint half the body and then make the video. Okay, I'm almost done. Just got a few more touch-ups to do, and I'll be done with the mane and tail. Depending on how fast you're going, I'm going like real fast, probably faster than I'd probably be good to go. There we go. So here's the finishing touches to the mane and tail. Her tail kind of comes up on her leg like that. There's her tail and her mane. She kind of looks like an Indian pony right here. Thanks for watching. Painting, remodel, repainting a Breyer horse. Bye.